Hello,
such
and
a
welcome
bop
back.
Every time. Sorry. I interrupted your intro. I'm sorry.
It is so, so good. Welcome back to another episode of Confessions of a Game Girl podcast. I am your host, Doom Cutie, and we've got a little bit of a change this week. Ellie is not feeling her best and ultimate self, and of course, that's what we want to see Ellie here at Confessions of a Game Girl. So she is. I've given her the day off. You know, no guilt around here. That's not how we work. And we finally got Miss Controller Craft, who's a moderator for us. If you've been with us for like since the first season, you would have seen her little face running around in the chat. So welcome. Love having you here. And obviously Shay is back. I can't get rid of her. She keeps coming back.
I don't even know how I got in here. I just like rocked up and she's like, I didn't even give you the link. And I'm like, oh boy, you don't need to. Gremlin my way in here. Like, I regret nothing.
I'm just realizing how much Shay and I look alike. We're both blonde hair, glasses. Mm-hmm. It's like you've got Shay in the discount Shay. I've got the reject shop Shay. I'm the
$2.7-11
sausage roll Shay.
Regular size Shay, fun size Shay.
which one's the fun size though?
Well, which one of us is shorter? I'm pretty little.
Okay, maybe you then.
I'm mini Shay. Just to confirm that Shay crossover, right? You guys obviously in the blurry background can see my cheeky bobbers. All that's my.
Oh yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So Rose being the absolute fucking champion, she is. Look at that. She has the same little guy.
He's just a little guy.
He's a little dude.
I was not prepared for a Bulbasaur off. just saying. We're not prepared. Anyway, thank you. Thank you for that. I can now put that on my list of skills on LinkedIn. Thank you. refereeing Bulbasaur offs.
Ooh.
Yeah. Anyway. Oh my goodness. It has it's been an eventful week for myself. But before I go ahead and, you know, enter my TED Talk era, because, you know, I don't have a diary, so you guys get to listen to all my crap. Thank you. I love you.
I'm sorry, is that not what we do on streaming? Have I been streaming wrong?
Maybe. Shay, how's your week been? What have you been playing?
Oh god, how's my week been? Anyway, so my week, I'm here and I have survived my week. But played some cheeky League of Legos. We're in split two of the season for this year, so that's fan-fucking-tastic. I'm playing a bunch more V-Rising because I cannot get that out of my brain. It's so beautiful. I love it so much. You know, you grab and snack on a people, and that's great. I love that. And then I played...
Just a little nibble.
Yeah, it's a little... It's fine. It's fine, you know? Like, and honestly, they're not alive to complain anyway, so realistically, there's no issue. There's no customer complaints. They can't complain. real service there. And then I play today, and you guys are going to love this because you all know that I get incredibly sick from first and third person games. Like, just simulation sickness hits me. So I played Fall Guys on my TikTok stream. Because this Friday I actually have a versus coming up on TikTok. So I have partnered with Ace Creators and they have put me in their TikTok partnership thingy. So that's really cool. So I'm streaming on TikTok now as well. I'm on all of your devices. You'll never escape me. So I play TikTok.
Yeah, you know how I feel.
Yeah, good. You'll love it. You'll do it. So I played Fall Guys in prep because I'm going to be versing someone on Friday. I don't even understand what the versing thing is. I don't know if like we need more likes or we need to win. I don't know what I'm doing.
Yeah, okay, like is it
hanging out with that person? I'm like, cool. So
hopefully
yeah,
they carry you.
Oh, they're gonna have to after today's performance. Actually, strangely enough, didn't do as badly as I thought. But I got like halfway through and I was like, I think I need to vomit.
Yeah,
I'm gonna die. And now I have this really awesome like bordering on migraine. The world is just doing one of these.
Yeah,
so that's been my gaming adventures for this week. But it's totally cool, and I will be victorious even through sickness. Thank you.
I have two confessions. One confession is, because, you know, we're about confessions around here.
It's true.
I saw you streaming on TikTok. I was like, who the fuck Shane on TikTok?
Oh, my God.
I did not know. She did not inform us. And when I was there, she was talking about Coag. You were like, yeah. And I was like, okay, get it, queen.
I got you. Off. I was
she would have again. Mentioned our TikTok there. Because TikTok is a different a different beast to hear.
It is.
To
I'm
hear.
Still learning so much. Oh, my God. People give me roses and stuff. I don't know what that is.
Well, we don't have the creator program, so you get nothing.
Oh, apparently I can access it if the people that I partner with go through to get it for me. I don't know.
Oh, they have American contacts. Exciting. Look, maybe I don't know. Yeah. That's cool. That sounds interesting. Mm-hmm. And my second confession is that I logged into Fall Guys one time to get the Doctor Who skins. Never again.
Oh, that's fair.
But they were very cute. Very cute. One is a TARDIS. One is a TARDIS, and I'm. It's
that is so cute. Oh my goodness. I actually haven't watched the new season yet, so don't spoil it for me if you've started watching it. But I'm desperate to watch it. But I've been a Doctor Who fan since I was in high school. And I have a really cool story to share with you. For my 20th birthday, Matt Smith came to Brisbane to do a little Doctor Who convention. It was Matt Smith, it was the Cheeky Baby Plays River Song and someone else, and they all came to Brisbane to do like a little mini Doctor Who.
Mum and Dad.
It was very tiny. Yeah, Mum and Dad. Alex Kingston, that's her name, isn't it? And I was wearing a TARDIS dress, and she was like, oh, I love the dress. And I was like, but it gets even better. Because Matt Smith sung me happy birthday. We were getting a little portrait signed. And I was like, oh, can I make a special request? He said, yeah, sure. I said, could you sign it happy 20th birthday? He said, oh, who's it for? I said, me, it's my birthday tomorrow. And then he goes, oh, happy birthday. And as if that wasn't enough, he then proceeds to sing me the entirety of the happy birthday song. And I was like, you know that, that TikTok? She's like screaming, but she's making no sound. She's like,
yeah, because like you don't want to even scream over the singing, but like,
oh my goodness,
I'm so proud of that,
first of all, well done for get the courage in that moment to forthright like that. And also that's like probably the best story we've had, in my opinion.
Shut down the podcast. Right. It's never going to peak after
this.
It's done.
Yeah, this is it.
Rose won the podcast. God damn it.
Rose, I know you've been on holiday this past week.
I have.
And what have you been gaming? What have you been up to?
So I've been doing a lot of boring chores, actually. I've been playing a cool game called Redacted, because I'm actually not allowed to talk about it because the embargo hasn't lifted. But I'm going to review it over on Quest Daily.
I thought you legitimately meant it's called Redacted. Yeah. I was like, oh, that's a new one. Is that like the naval one? Oh, cool.
Surprise.
Cool.
No, I'm not allowed to talk about it yet. The embargo lifts 2 a.m. Friday morning, so there'll be a review over on Quest Daily for that bad boy.
So what I did is like, hit up at 2:01 and be like, yo, Rose.
What are you wearing right now? What are you doing?
Wow.
You're like, I'm clearly wearing merch. Gosh.
I'm wearing my Bulbasaur onesie and I'm playing Redacted, obviously. Like,
really? What were you even asking?
So I've been playing that. I have also been playing a lot of really idle games lately, just because I've been flat out obviously finishing up at my previous job, which we'll get into in a bit, before I start my new job. But during that period, it's just sort of been like pretty much all day I'm just flat out from the time I get up to the time I go to bed. So I get like a few minutes in the evening where it's like, oh, okay, so I'll boot up like Leaf Blower or Chillquarium. Games where it's just kind of like I can duck in, do a bit of management, and then just leave it run itself and walk away. I also 100%ed Rusty's Retirement on Steam. That was my first ever 100%ed game on Steam. So that's
congratulations.
Cool.
See, now, congratulations. Now you're a real gamer, right?
You've
100%. Therefore,
hell yeah.
Yep.
Absolutely. I've also been plugging away at Baldur's Gate very slowly.
Oh, good, yes,
that's a slow burn, but you know, that's how we like it, right?
That's got so much content. Like, when people are like, yeah, I got through it in like a small amount of time, I'm like, you missed everything, didn't you? You didn't look at anything. Like, it's not a rush game. It's not that kind of thing. No,
it is not. Definitely don't play Baldur's Gate if you're looking for a quickie.
Well, I mean,
or maybe.
Or maybe.
Asterion. No.
Or maybe. Saying,
man, that dude who stuck his head out the goddamn portal. Maybe.
Maybe I let him.
But
in
what if?
You know what I mean.
I've completely lost my train of thought. In regard to
talking about
you're Asterion now, like, yeah, I know. I'm with you. I feel it.
There's too many thirst traps. Absolutely. For that.
All right, Shay, tell me, who is your favorite in Baldur's Gate?
You're getting a real mad, right? I didn't actually play enough of it, and I didn't learn anyone's names. So my favorite, actually, and this is terrible, because whenever I play these games where I can speak to animals, it's always the animals.
Yeah.
So in Baldur's Gate 3, it was the rat that's guarding the warehouse. He's so cute. I love him so much. He's just doing a little rat thing.
He's just a little guy.
And he's just like, da, 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 da. And he like talks. Yeah. Hands down, everyone else can die in a fire. I don't care. Like, the little rat is my friend. And then like in Divinity Original Sin 2, the sassy crab on the beach. She was so mean. I was like, you're a crab, lady. You're a crab. And she's just like, and I'm like, okay. And I loved her so much. So, you know.
Yeah, that's fair.
The humans, I'm like, yeah, there's that chick who's like kind of sassy in my camp. She's got a ponytail and some sort of like dark religion. I don't know. She's a rat, I guess. But anyway, have you seen this rat?
Yeah.
I like him. He's very cool.
So I'm actually playing with my best mate at the moment. And one of our favorite things, this isn't too much of a spoiler because I believe it happens in the first chapter, but you can optionally, if you do all the right things, befriend a little owlbear cub. Have you seen an owlbear?
No, not yet.
It's like the body of a bear, but the head of an owl. It's just
I've seen
baby.
Like drawings of them before. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, they're so cute. And it gets even cuter because if you have like a druid or someone who has speak with animals, then he obviously has a voice, and the voice actor is like, more, give me more scratches, I want more, and it's so cute. It's like,
I will give you scratches forever, my tiny friend. You will never be without, I promise.
Wow. Protect the owlbears.
Yeah.
At all costs.
And the mean crab.
At all costs.
That ox guy can...
Oh, yeah, that ox guy is so weird.
Dodgy, like, dude.
Like, you know, fairies be fairies.
Anyway. Yeah, like, I'm like, why an ox? Like, you could have been anything. Could have been a bird.
Speaking of fairies, the game I've been playing this week is potentially full of them. a couple of fairy things have been in my life. Last week we spoke about my adoration for a particular cat, and sorry? How it's not, well, aww. It's kind of another one.
He's pretty
sorry.
Cute.
Yeah.
That's okay, I guess. He's
hurt. Yes, last week I was a big fan of Little Kitty Big City.
Oh,
and
yes.
And this week I have stepped back into, some people might say it's habitual and addictive, but World of Warcraft, Mr. Pandaria remix. Blizzard, BNZ, hello. Yes, Blizzard is happening. It's bringing back its Cataclysm what is it, Classic? I don't play Classic. I play Retail. But this remix takes me back to like my favorite expansion. It was the first expansion that I actually leveled, like started at the beginning, like from the very start, and I knew what was happening. And Mr. Pandaria is it's set on an back, it's the back of a turtle. Pandaria is on the back of a turtle, and it's grassy and it's very, very Japanese inspired.
Chinese.
Or Chinese, Japanese.
Eastern.
Yeah, there's pretty sure there's like Balinese in there, and anyway,
intricate detailing. It's lovely.
It really is lovely, and I'm basically just leveling from the very beginning. I don't have any of my stuff. They've taken everything away, so it's kind of like Diablo. How there's like the eternal realm, and then there's the seasonal realm. This is like a season. This is a season, and there are rewards that you can get that are like account wide if you do particular achievements. And it's anyway, it's feeding anyone who is a fan of transmog, anyone who's an achievement hunter, a mount hunter. You can go back and you can get all these amazing outfits and. They've rejigged some of the mounts, like some of them look pretty. And
Doom, I've got somebody that I think you know, but you should probably go and watch Fiamma. She's gotten her account up to 900th. Blah blah blah.
Yes. I will say, and I was actually going to tweet her today that I got my 150 mount achievement.
Ooh. Yes! Oh my god!
Not that I was going for it, but yeah. And when
not that I was trying.
No, it was just organic, you know. All natural.
Wasn't Fiamma a guest on the first season of Coag? Isn't that who I'm thinking
of? Certainly was.
Yeah, there we go. See, I'm all over the Coag lore. I know what's up.
I totally watched
Coag lore. Yes,
the Coag wiki. I've been reading it.
Oh my god, do we have a wiki? I'm gonna put some unhinged things in there.
Oh, don't. Oh, can you imagine?
Break my feet.
Anyway. How tall is Shay, actually?
I wish I had enough of an internet presence that I had a feet wiki. Like, I'm so curious to know what my feet wiki score would be. Like, just
what
there is there is a part of me that really wants to know.
Like, would you be like, oh wow, okay, like what's wrong with my beans? Like, what's wrong with my feet?
It gets even gross, even worse, because I actually have a condition called psoriasis, a skin condition called psoriasis, and I get it really bad on the bottom of my feet. So
maybe you have, like, it's rare collector feet.
Yeah, it's one of those things, right? Does that bump up my score? Does it knock it down a peg? Someone's got to be into that, right?
Does it make
so,
it
like,
niche?
I don't know.
I don't know.
Is it like shinies in Pokemon? Is it like, you know? Like
you have shiny rare feet!
Yeah. Rose. We don't have any services in regards to feet pics, so please do not DM any of us for those. Thank you very much.
Yes, sorry.
I can say that the pandas in World of Warcraft don't wear feet, wear shoes, so you can see their feet all the time.
Oh, there you go.
I pictured immediately like a panda wearing a human foot, and it was horrible.
Oh, now I can see that thing.
Yeah. Nothing about
But unfortunately, like the end of Dragonflight is coming like soon, and I'm very sad because I have thoroughly enjoyed Dragonflight, and we've gotten to see like heaps of lore around the different aspects and the different like. I don't know, I guess the Hogwarts houses of dragons in in World of Warcraft. So it's now you've given dolphin ideas for Photoshop. Thank you. I really enjoyed my time, and my guild is really cool. So, and yeah, like we said, Fiamma, who we've had on the podcast before, she's a big fan as well. So is Haughty Chicken. She is a special best friends with Blizzard, which is cool as well. We also had Aaron Goldsmith, who actually works as a talent manager at Blizzard. And she's a LinkedIn influencer as well. So I'm definitely check her out.
On that front, that episode was by far, if you haven't like gone back to watch that episode or you missed it live, go back after this and watch it, because that whole LinkedIn stuff that she was talking us through and everything, that like changed part of my career. I've like upped my LinkedIn game and I've like set it all up. That was where I was job.
Oh, I've seen it, girl.
On my resume. Like, yeah, like it is
just
it is a legit, like
if I wanted to find that episode, what number would that be?
Oh, that is a great question. It was one of the earlier ones, yeah.
Let me... Erin Goldsmith, she was on episode 8 of season 1.
Easy. I'm gonna go find that.
Yeah. 10 out of 10 would recommend giving that one a bad.
Yeah, she had a lot of fantastic things to say, and just watch them all until it plays. True. Our first episode compared to this episode is actually wild. Like, I have deliberately not watched them because I've grown so much as a host. And yes, we can all look back and, you know, obviously upgrade, you know,
of course.
And reflect on the things that, you know, we would like to improve. But I think the general vibe that I've known throughout my progress as a host. But I'll never hide them, okay? They're always going to be out there. Like, I'm a sweaty mess in some of the Coag in the Wild episodes, and I just have to deal with it because at the end of the day, I'd never set out for this to be, like, particularly well-polished. I meant it to be something that is, like, authentic. And I think, and I've just gotten an idea. What if we did, like, Coag reacts to, like, previous episodes?
Ooh.
That's about a season 3 or 4, I reckon. You do like podcasts when they go into like season 3 or 4, and then they do like compilation videos and like stuff like that. Absolutely. Yeah. We could do one where we go back and we're like, lol. Yeah. For real.
Yeah.
Can talk about you scaring people by informing them that women sweat. That's terrible. People didn't know that. That's
mean. I know. I'm sorry.
Yeah, fun fact, women don't fart.
Yeah, just exactly.
Biologically, not there.
Yeah. It just stays in the body, and then over time it makes us cranky, I think. That's how that works, right?
You know, I heard.
Messes, right?
Yeah.
The unreleased farts. No, I I heard
Taylor's version, unreleased farts.
Censored version.
We also don't sell audio clips of farts. Please don't DM us.
I do have one. Like, it's not of me, but it's on my
stream. Oh, God, of course you do. Shame.
It's on my stream deck for stream. I also have emojis of damage for clapping. It's not my fart.
Oh,
God, I wish I could do it. No, it was a 10 out of 10 fart, though. Like,
I dare you to, like, replace it one day.
It'd be like it wouldn't even be impressive. That's not fun. I want a meaty 10 out of 10 toot. Thank you.
Oh, dear. Look, there are two kinds of people in this world.
Mm-hmm.
One are people that enjoy fart jokes.
Mm.
The other kind are the ones that don't. I am part of the people that don't. And I can see that you guys are on team do.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
And it doesn't mean that I don't have a sense of humor, because I definitely do. However, yeah. We will not be getting a fart button here, okay? And for good reason. So if you wish to see that, go over to Shay.
I'm so tempted to just hit the fart button.
Don't! Do it. All right.
No,
all right. Let's move on. We've spent 25 minutes, almost half the episode, on
this.
Tootin' and scootin'.
Do not make me cuss.
I need that on a shirt with a little frog and like a cowboy hat and cowboy boots. Just like,
he's got a little like fart cloud.
Can frog fart?
I'll find out.
Hold on. Yeah, please, someone. I have to know. Could you imagine the cute little toots?
Ooh.
Frog. Ooh.
Okay.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, so salamanders and frogs have weak sphincters and probably don't fart, but could.
It's coming out all the time. That's what that sounds like.
Yeah, so they don't even get to save it up for the loud impact.
Damn.
There you go, the more you know. Look, the more you know. I dare say, look, people have always come away being informed from Confessions of a Gamer Girl.
Yeah, and, educational.
Look, I was hoping that it would be like, you know, in mindfulness or mental health or gaming or career. No,
wildlife.
No. About random animal facts and their sphincters. Like,
yeah.
About their sphincters.
Mm-hmm. It's moving a great conversation. It's an icebreaker.
Yeah, like, did you know frogs don't fart, but they could?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, like, the sea is going to part real quick. You're going to get the people that are actually interesting, like, oh, really? And the other people are like, oh, that's gross. These people suck. That,
this push is, those this away. Is now my new like, Hinge dating profile prompt, just
oh
like.
Oh, my God, yes. And you'll get the best, like, I didn't know that. How did you come across that? Or, oh, my God, that, but also, and then you get to learn more facts.
Exactly.
I'm only seeing positives.
Yeah.
It's all good.
Can't go wrong.
Exactly. Look, you're always winning. You're always winning when you're here with Confessions of a Gaming Girl. Speaking of winning, Rose has somehow cracked. She's cracked the employment world in regards to gaming in Australia, because this lady has been working in the behind the scenes of gaming retail for
about 3 years. Yeah.
Okay, and she was made redundant. And what, 1 week later, 2 weeks later, she has secured herself another position. So that is a win for me. Well done, darling. Congratulations.
Woo, thank you very much.
Claps for Rose. Clap in the chat. I'll ban you. I'm kidding.
Hell yeah. So let me clarify some things, because redundancy in the gaming sphere, as we know, is a pretty big deal. People are getting laid off all the time, and it's a really, really difficult environment. And here in Australia, there's lots of like laws and stuff that protect people from that kind of thing, right? You can't just sort of be kicked out the door like you seemingly can be in America and places like that, right?
Yeah.
So my position wasn't necessarily made redundant as much. It was just kind of like, oh, you're not permanent, so we're going to reduce your hours considerably to the point where you're going to want to leave. And it was like, okay, I can take the hint, I'll leave.
Yeah, right.
Like, you don't want to pay rent or eat food, did you? Cool.
No. Yeah, no. Didn't need a food over my head, a roof over my head and food in my belly. Didn't need food over my head either, actually. But,
there you go.
Yeah, here we are. So yeah, no, that fun times here in the economy. Woo.
Yeah. Now I do say, like, probably a lot of people wanted to be in your position. Like, I feel like it's like a sought after kind of role.
I legit applied for that role. So like,
yeah. People. When I tell people what my job was, people go, oh, like usually when it's like I have to go to the doctors or I have to go somewhere where there's like sort of middle-aged or older people and I tell them my job, they're like, oh, my son would love your job. You have my son's dream job, or you have my nephew's dream job. I'm like, I know, I have everyone's dream job. It was the best job in the world, and I loved every second of it, and I didn't take it for granted at all.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The only thing is, I feel like so many of these, dream jobs or, ideal positions, they come at a cost. And I feel like that cost is security.
Yeah, yep. Absolutely. 110%. Yeah. So shall we rip the Band-Aid off and I'll tell everyone what I did?
Oh, yeah, that might be a good idea. Guys, did you tell what Rose actually did?
That could
be fun.
So I worked for EB Games as one of their social media managers. So I worked on a team of people that were content creators and social media mods for EB Games Australia, which, if you're from overseas, EB Games is the Australian GameStop. They're pretty big deal here in Australia.
There's a lot of stock issues, and not just physical stock. I mean, stock
so
market
funny,
issues.
Though, Reddit went. Mm-hmm. Anyway, so sorry. Please continue.
Yes. No. And I know a lot of people, like, when they're a teenager, they're like, yeah, I'm gonna work at EB Games, and like, maybe one day, like, I'll run the place, or but it doesn't have a linear career progression. There's like all these different sections and they're all separate. No one knows anyone.
No.
I never met the owner.
So I started working off in stores, actually. So Let me give you a bit of Rose lore, a bit of Rose backstory.
Yeah.
So I actually worked as a counsellor for nearly 10 years. I worked in primary schools, working with children and young people, in various therapy roles. And one day I realized that I could be earning twice as much if I actually went and got my degree instead of my diploma. So I went back to uni. And while I was at uni, I was like, I could use a casual job to get me by. So I went and applied for EB Games.
All right. Games Fair.
So I worked in stores for about a year and a half while I was finishing off my degree. And then I went out into the world for about 6 months and like did some counseling stuff and went, this sucks. I want to go back into games. And at the time, the EB Games head office had a position open for a social media content creator. It was a casual position. I knew what I was getting myself into, that it wasn't permanent full time. But I was like, yeah, I'll do that part time and counseling part time. And that'll sort of, you know, fill the void. And so I did that for a little while until I realized that I really wasn't sort of vibing the counseling side of things anymore. So I left. And at the time, things were looking quite positive, sort of in the economy in general. You know, and so it was one of those things where I was like, yeah, I'll go like work for EB Games. You know, people were like, oh, maybe full time, maybe. No one promised anything. There's nothing like illegal or dodgy that anyone did. But there was talks, right? There was sort of like, oh, yeah, well, if you're into full time, we'd love to have you. Let's chat about this more at some point, you know.
A situationship kind of.
Yeah. A situationship. That is exactly what it is. I have been in a situationship with EB Games for the last 2 years. Oh, anyway.
Sounds like a confession. Like, that's just right, that's fair.
Ultimate confession.
Ultimate confession. And so.
But your hopes were high.
And... My hopes were high. And then every few months, I try and have a discussion, be like, hey, like, I love my job, you know, and not to toot my own horn, but they loved me. Right? People, everyone higher up was like, this chick is it. She's got it. She's awesome. She's going to go far. It sort of seemed like every time I had a review, I got like the highest scores. Nothing bad was ever said about me. It was like everyone loved me. It was popping off. I felt like I was doing a really good job. And so I was kind of like, yeah, like permanent full time is on its way. This is it. This is my future. This is everything. And then sort of every time I had that discussion, it was the same thing. And a lot of those decisions weren't just from sort of the higher ups. They were from higher up and overseas, where it was kind of like, hey, like we're trying to sort of cut costs. We're not trying to sort of we're looking at our overheads. We're looking at how many people we've got on. And so everything's just kind of casual. But they were really good to me. So because they quite liked me a lot, they tended to give me full-time hours, but as a casual. So it lacked the permanency, but I had the paycheck to keep me going. So I didn't mind. It was sort of this like non-contractual contract that we had where it was like, hey, you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours, right? Like, and that happened up until a couple of weeks ago. When right as they gave me a pay increase and I got my annual review and they were like, you're the bomb.com, we love you to death, a week later they pulled me into the office, and my managers, to their credit, they are some of the best people. They looked like they were about to cry, and I was like, oh no, what's happening? Aww. And they were like, yeah, so hours are reducing. Yeah, right. And I was like, oh, okay. You know, and they said, look, we wanted to give you as much heads up as possible. We didn't want to sort of lead you on. And you know, my manager, to their credit, actually said to me, they said, as your friend, I think you should look for work elsewhere because I think you are worth more. And I think, you know, that you're sort of, you know, maybe just kind of like, not being appreciated as much as you could be here, I think is probably the politically correct way of putting it. And so he was like, as your friend, I actually think you'd be better off elsewhere, but also please don't leave me.
So tough. Oh my so gosh. Tough.
This is, but you know, I mean, to be fair, it's one of those things at the moment, the economy's so crap that like, even as an employee of the company, you know, I used to, like a little peek into behind the curtains of my financial situation, I used to spend thousands of dollars a year at EB Games, you know, buying Pokemon cards and plushies and whatever else.
Because you're around it all the time.
Yeah. Exactly. And now that like I can barely afford food most weeks, It's like, well, I'm not really going to go out and buy a plushie. And same with the rest of Australia. So no one's shopping. And so when no one's shopping, there's no money in the company. So they can't afford to give me the shifts. So they have to cut the shifts, right?
And the first people to go are entertainers and artists, always.
Always. So that was really rough. But even like up until my very last day, they were really nice to me. They were really good to me. They were like making me work hard up until the last day because they were like, don't know what we're going to do without you, so please.
Create 6 months worth of content for us. Thank you.
It felt like that. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, wow.
And so, yeah, it's one of those things where it's just an unfortunate byproduct of the economy that we're in at the moment.
Yeah.
But it was heartbreaking. It was absolutely heartbreaking to leave.
Well, I dare say that your colleague is correct, that you are definitely already appreciated in other spaces and you will continue to be increasingly appreciated. You've put yourself out there so, so much, and I feel like you've grown so much, even in the time that I've known you. I think you should be really, really proud of yourself, never giving up and always just putting 100% into everything you do. So well done to you.
Thank you so much. No, it's I feel like I've grown a lot as an entertainer, a presenter, a content creator, as a marketer in general, especially considering I don't have a degree in the field. And
yeah, that's wild.
I can't talk about my next role yet. It was really funny that the job listing actually said, marketing degree and 3 years experience in this specific field. And I was like, I have no degree and 0 years experience in the exact thing you want me to do. But
I'm fine.
I'm fun and I work hard. And they're like, job, yours.
Yes. Honestly, yeah, like you work for a prestigious company, like despite That's everything. It. Like they would have seen that. They would have been like, she's the real deal. And you probably got glowing reviews from your references. And so
my boss put in a really good word for me. He was very kind.
Yeah. I must ask, so you say that, you went into this role, not knowing, anything in regards to, your degree, it's not related at all to your job. Did you find that you picked up a lot of soft skills along the way, during your time on Instagram, with streaming, with, writing?
Yeah. Yeah. So it was one of those things. Obviously, I'd done some content creation personally, right? That was sort of what I put on my resume to get the job with EB. I was like, oh, hey, I'm Control of Craft. You've even shared some of my photos before. Like, you kind of know me. And they were like, oh, yeah, we kind of know you. Come in for an interview. You know what I mean? I had come from a counseling background. And it was one of those things where I was just kind of like, I just gotta nail the interview, right? Which I did, got the job, and it was exactly that. It was one of those things where I had some soft skills, right? I had dabbled in different fields before. They were looking at doing streaming. So EP Games have started doing streaming on Instagram and Facebook. And at the time, those were just dreams, right? Like when I started a couple of years ago, they were like, oh, wouldn't it be cool if we did that one day? And so when I was like, hey, at the time I was a massive Twitch streamer, right? So I was like, hey, I'm a Twitch streamer. And they were like, we like that. We like that a lot. And along the way, you pick up marketing things, especially helped that my manager had a marketing degree had been in the field for several years. So he was the kind of guy who could be like, let me educate you or let me explain why we do or don't do something and what works and what doesn't work. So you definitely pick up things along the way. I definitely feel like I'm a lot more confident in marketing now. It makes me think of, I don't know if you guys remember that episode of Friends where Chandler changes his career and Monica has the big binder and she's like, let's look at all the different careers you could change to. And the first one was advertising. And he was like, advertising, I could do that. And that whole I think that's over a couple of episodes, that little story arc is me. It was me when I was leaving counseling and I was like, advertising, I could sell a video game, let's go.
she closed her eyes on the career map and went, ah, that's the one.
Yeah, literally.
No, but I tell you what, as a typical type B personality, I always grow with the flow and the vibe of things, and when I just feel like I just get opportunities or I say yes to things and I put myself out there and then things work out. And I know that's very, triggering for some people out there who are type A, do this, do that, like all the time. But for me, it has always been that way. And I feel like that you were like, you know what? I like games. Oh, I could do that. I'm educated. And you know what? Most people who have had tertiary education can probably easily learn most of these kinds of jobs, I think. Like,
you hope.
Yeah. It's one of those things, especially in my new job, when I picked up the phone, they were like, we're going to offer you the job. They were like, you seem like you're a really hard worker. We can teach you the rest. And that is like, that is most jobs.
Can't in teach fact, work ethic.
You passed the vibe check and they were like, that one. Yeah.
Exactly. Because a crappy employee will make or break a workplace. I worked with one of those recently, trust me. And like, the ability to work hard and get along with others, those are things you cannot teach an adult, right? Like, unless they go to years and years of therapy, like, they've already got to come with that, right? So if you've got those two things, almost everything else can be taught. So just, like, that is what has got to get you through the door, really. You don't want to hire someone who's going to bring a bad vibe, a crappy work ethic, all that kind of stuff. Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely, like, the soft skills, but mixed with problem solving, just basic problem solving.
Yeah.
Like, and the ability to sit with discomfort at times, because, like, it's uncomfortable not knowing. It truly is. Like, none of us like it. It's not fun. But the ability to sit with it and go, I'm still going to find a pathway through this. It's such a valuable skill set.
It is. Yeah, like, at the moment, you know, we've mentioned already, like, such an economic downturn. Yeah. I mean, there are people that are kind of in jobs that they don't really enjoy. And, I mean, Rose, I can only imagine, like, if it – yeah, I don't know what kind of pressure that put on you financially. I mean, you said that you did struggle. I don't know if you had like family to support you, or did you have like a lot of savings, or, you know, like, but I mean, you're here today, and you've obviously, you know, like, if you do go through a time like that and you're like, you know what, I don't even have enough money for groceries this week, or I can't pay my phone bill or my rent or something like that, like, the last thing you want to do is like log onto a computer, use electricity, use your internet, and, you know, like, apply for jobs.
Stressing the whole time as well. Like, stress doesn't turn off. It's not like other kinds of stress where you can remove yourself from the environment and maybe reset. It's with you forever.
Yeah.
It is.
Is there anything difficult you could recommend? People out there are struggling at the moment and in a transition, at a crossroads, if you will.
I mean, it's one of those things, I guess, as a counselor, I could say, like, you know, all the typical things, right? Like, you got to have loved ones to support you, reaching out to those guys. For me, it was a friend, because I recently had a bit of I'm fine now financially, just for the record, but in the last few weeks, I have not been so. And I had a friend come over for my birthday a couple of weeks ago. She goes, what do you want? Like, you know, like, do you want this? Do you want that? Do you want, you know, like, Pokemon cards, whatever? And I was like, Sophie, I haven't had a proper meal in a month. I have been living off of soup. Could I please have some groceries?
Yeah, right.
It do be like that, though.
Yeah.
I was like, no, because her love language is gifts, right? So yeah, I was like, I know you want to give me things, but you know what I actually really need right now?
Food.
I need milk and bread.
A meal?
I need long life milk and all of the basics for making. Thank you.
And to her credit, she didn't just like come over with a meal. She filled my entire fridge, my entire freezer, and my entire pantry. And to the point where it was overflowing. And I am literally in tears right now as I'm talking about this. But I was crying because my fridge has never been that full ever. I have owned that fridge for about 2.5 years. It has never been that full.
Yeah.
And I was just like, it's one of those things where I think it's almost like a rite of passage as a young adult that you have to kind of go through to be like, I have had a moment of like depravity and poverty, and like I was just eating tin soup, you know, and now I'm here. So that was
for anybody who hits that moment, heads up, instead of soup, go beans. It gives you your protein intake.
Yeah, I hate beans.
I hate beans too, but trust me, like, after a month of soup and dropping way too many kilos,
yeah,
as a personal note, from genuine experience, beans.
Oh my days.
Well, yeah.
Yep.
So yeah, like it's.
I think the other thing as well, in any point in life, is asking for help. You know, because if I didn't have the courage or drop the pride to be able to say to Sophie, you know what I actually really need? Can I be real with you and raw with you and vulnerable with you and tell you what I actually really need for my birthday? I actually need food. That was actually. Well, on the one hand, it was easy because I guess I've been through enough in life that I no longer find that challenging. But knowing when I was younger, doing something like that was very challenging. It is difficult to humble yourself and ask someone for help. You know, people are always saying, that, oh, you gotta ask for help. Are you okay, Day? Better help, whatever, right? The people are always on the internet being like, oh, yeah, just ask for help. Just ask for help. You should just ask for help. It's actually really difficult to ask for help. Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
It is
and
difficult.
Sometimes. Like, even knowing what to ask for help for. Like, for yours, it was very clear, luckily. It's, like, literal food.
Yeah.
But sometimes, you know, depending on the situation, you don't even know what to ask for. You're just like, I don't know, man. I'm just not okay and I need help.
Yeah.
Like, please. But it is hard. It is hard. But you sound like you've got a really good friend. Like,
I've got some great friends.
That sounds so goddamn good.
Yeah.
Like, you want food? We'll get you food.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can I just say, Rose, I tell you, the next time you are in that, you are getting into my DMs, young lady. Thank you very much.
It's true. It's true.
All right. Well, you go into the admin channel and you say, hey, guys, here's my
literally need food.
Please. I'd be like,
here's my list
of
allergies. Teehee, help. Yeah, no.
No, I will give you cold, hard cash, babe. Jeez. Wee.
Well, thank you. That's very kind. Look, it wasn't like at the moment, like I'm living with family, right? So it's one of those things where it was like I was making ends meet just if I ate soup. I wasn't in that dire strait. But it was when Sophie came to me and was like, what do you want for your birthday? That I was then able to turn around and be like.
I think it's really important to remember, though, like, soup for an entire month, not healthy, but B, humans are very, very good at adapting and seeing the best in the situation that may actually be genuinely dangerous for them. So
true.
Good on you for loving soup. Like, awesome.
No.
But also, pumpkin soup is very good. Like, I would say that that's probably kind of getting serious at that point. Yeah. So like, true. Yeah, true. It's just that, you know.
Is my skin turning Donald Trump? Shade of orange from all the pumpkin I've been eating. Like,
I was just saying, your skin looks really smooth. Maybe soup's like what?
Hey, all I'm saying is if you did go orange, you could have been a child's entertainer at birthday parties as an Oompa Loompa. Just saying.
You could have been the new
TikTok. Oh, at the Wonka experience. That was me, bro.
No.
You would have made that. Oh, man. We would have paid $40 to see you.
Loompa.
And now we get it for free. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
That's so good. Look at this.
Just for you. Does that up my feet score? I hope so. But yes.
Are you orange?
They're shiny. They're rare. Oh, my gosh. Everything comes full circle.
Shiny beans.
Shiny beans. They look like baked beans because they're beans and they're orange.
Oh, my God. And then you're just going to put them in sauce and you're actually a baked bean. It's horrible. You're essentially making wine out of, like, ew. Yucky. I mean, everything. My That's brain so needs to good. Stop now.
Lovely.
Thank you.
But yes, so my biggest advice to people in that position to come back round would be to be brave, be bold, and just, you know, ask for help. Yeah.
Yeah.
And reach out to people that you might not feel as close to as you'd like, but reach out, like, especially on this topic. So obviously we're talking about reaching out to friends and family, but if you don't have any, and I have been in that situation where it's ask for help.
Yeah,
there's no one to ask. It gets hard, but reach out to literally fucking anybody, dude, because, like, speaking from experience, it only gets harder. So, like, just reach out.
And there's helplines, there's free things out there, there's local organizations, churches, all those sorts of people who are all there to help you. So,
like, literally type into Google, low income help, and then like your suburb or something, there's going to be something like genuinely
and like
a food bank.
I don't know if you said this before, but yeah, like even just go to someone who's really knowledgeable and just be like, hey, like I'm in this situation. Like, what would you do? What resources are out there for me? This podcast has taken quite the turn today, but you know what? It's important. It's important that we talk about this. You know what's taken quite a turn? My children. So I do apologize that my camera and my mic has been a bit on and off. Please,
yeah, you're fine.
No, we've taken that as like party time. Like, mom's gone. We're gonna
party time.
Shay and Discount Shay are here having a little
Shay from Wish
party joke time while you're out. Yeah,
it's gonna be great. Like, one day you're gonna come into the podcast. It's just gonna be like tiny Shay, regular size Shay. Doom's gonna be off in the corner, like knocking on
the rocking and back and forth.
Yeah, we'd be like, oh boy, we're doing the podcast today.
I think
he's gonna have like an aneurysm.
Speaking of that, I'm just this kind of leans into the topic I did want to a little bit touch on, but so gaming events, PAX is coming up, and I can just imagine in our community meetup, I'm like, I'm tied to a chair, gagged, like tape. It's like washi tape though. It's like cute Hello Kitty or Pokemon or something. You know,
it's not even threatening. It's just like adorable.
Yeah, it's just like it's cute. And then I'm just tied to the chair, and like so you guys can just, you know, have your fun.
I will gremlin dance around you. Straight up. I'll have a Bulbasaur above my head and we'll be like,
I'll let the dogs out.
Yeah, straight up.
The dogs.
Rose is going to be there singing for me, preferably off key, and yeah. I'm just going to be...
That is the only key that I can sing in is off key, so...
That's the only one. I want it to be like the weird kazoo memes. Thank you. Oh, get a kazoo.
Oh, please don't bring a kazoo.
Can we get...
I'm patting you down before you enter. For a kazoo, like absolutely not.
Or an ocarina, I'll take either. Like, I'm just saying, we've got options.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah. I can't play an ocarina, but that makes it better.
Yeah, 100%.
Oh, my days. Look, if I have to eat beans and soup until October to get to PAX, that's what I'm going to do.
Hashtag worth it.
I gotta still book my accommodation. I'm so scared. Like, I've been getting so many messages from people like, hey, have you booked your accommodation? I'm like, why are we freaking out about this now? And apparently there's a concert or something happening the same weekend. So like, a lot of the accommodation.
Olivia Rodrigo, I think.
Okay. All I know is this lady's getting in the way of my PAX time and I won't have it. So
That's right. We'll just crash at Ellie's house. Yeah. I see no problem with this.
Yeah, Ellie or Tika, I'll just bust down some doors and be like, oi nerds, I'm here.
Oh. Ellie, Tika.
That's it.
Done. Easy. Yeah. Or we'll crash
in the lounge room.
Who else is going? I don't know. We'll just crash the hotels. We'll like hotel hop.
Oh, yeah.
Either that or we just get a big team Airbnb and we'll make bunk beds for more room for activities.
See, Shay, darling, there's a reason why. Okay, there's a reason why I have not suggested team bunk beds. Okay.
Because you're
I enjoy my sleep.
I can take the top bunk. It's all good.
Okay. Serious chat. Weird sleeping quirks. What are your weird sleeping quirks?
Drooling.
I don't really sleep.
You don't really sleep, so you're insomnia.
I toss and turn constantly, and I wake up drenched in sweat because I have constant nightmares.
Okay, excellent. Love that for you.
Yeah.
I said quirks, not
it's not a quirk.
PTSD.
Oh, it's a quirk. PTSD's quirky.
And oh, do you like wake up in a panic like you're falling?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
We love a PTSD queen. What do you mean?
Well, cool, because you got it. But like my pet peeve is when you're just falling asleep and you're about to drift off and then like in your mind you're skipping or something and you trip and you're like, and you're like, what the actual fuck? Yeah. You're just on the couch or you're on the bed and all of a sudden now you're tripping.
Yeah.
On what?
Yeah.
Anyway, Rose, your turn. What do you sleep?
I actually sleepwalk. That is my fun sleeping quirk. Oh, which is why I I don't like having to like share a hotel room with someone or whatever because I do some very weird things in my sleep.
So we actually do need to tie you down. Love
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, so there is reason for the ropes.
Yeah, there's yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. We've got some interesting ones in the chat as well. We have a really nice one, which is I track my sleep with Pokemon every night. That's actually just adorable.
Oh, yeah. The Pokemon sleep. Do you play Pokemon
Apparently
sleep?
That's... I haven't got it, but I'm going to have to because it sounds so cute. But I'd lose because I don't sleep. These eye bags, guys, have always been there. They're not new. So we've got another one, which I can actually relate to. Can't sleep unless I'm watching a video because otherwise my brain does not stop.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Just have to put focus elsewhere because you can't turn your own brain off. And then I really love this one. Sleep like a Master Chief death pose.
Yeah.
Excellent. I envy the hips. You know? I love it. Yeah. And then we have, I always mess up this word.
Paralysis.
Paralysis. Oh my God.
Paralysis.
Paralysis. Thank you. Paralysis/paralysis. I sleep on my back.
You're both wrong.
We try.
Said it confidently.
Paralysis.
No one would have cared.
That confidence. Also, we have had it pointed out that perhaps Rose should not have the top bunk, just in case.
Yeah.
That's fine. No, you can be the monster under the bed if you want.
Can you climb ladders?
I don't know
if I can climb a ladder in my sleep. Would you like to hear some of the things I've done in my sleep?
Yes.
I have booted up my computer and messed with my OBS settings in my sleep. No. That is how my Twitch community found out that I sleepwalk because I had what happens is when I sleepwalk.
Did you sleep stream?
Nearly.
That'd be wild.
Oh my God. Yes.
So I think I must sleepwalk with my eyes open because I tend to dream about what I'm doing. I tend to have a dream that I get up and I do something around the house. And then I wake up the next day. Like the next day or something, you know, and you're like, oh, that's weird. Like, you know, and someone will be like, oh, you were up and about last night. And I was like, was I? So it's one of those things where it's like, in the past, I have gone to the fridge and gotten snacks and eaten snacks in my sleep. I've woken up in the middle of the kitchen holding a packet of Tim Tams. Just like, why not? I have a considerably younger brother. And so when I was a kid, I had this dream that I got up, walked into my brother's room, picked up some of his plushies and brought them back into my room. And then I woke up with the plushies in my hand and I was like, what? That was the first time I was there's something right about that.
Honestly, that's better than how I thought that was gonna go. So like, good.
I could just beat my brother. I just
casually smothered my sibling. Like, oh, that's good. Right, I love that for you. How's that going?
Great.
Oh, good.
Yeah, I've done some stranger things as well, but yeah, it's one of those things where I tend to sort of do a cheeky walk from time to time. I also do a cheeky, this is actually really funny. As part of working in primary schools, oftentimes they want you to like go on school camps and things like that.
Oh, and you're like,
yeah, I was like, no, you cannot take me on a school camp. Like, as much as I want to be there for the kids and do the other stuff, I can't. And one of the reasons that I would give is obviously the sleepwalking stuff. And I would say, let me give you an example of a time when in my sleep, I sleep stripped and walked around the house in the buff.
Whoops.
And I'm like, can't do that on a school camp. That's going to cause legal problems.
You're like, actually, genuinely, I don't want these charges. Please don't send me.
Please don't make me
stop every child. Let's not do this. And so thankfully, I will
cover year 12 chemistry, okay? I will go into that class and pretend like I know what I'm doing just so I don't get myself into that position. Yeah. Thank you very much, principal.
Yeah, we're going to look at the chemistry of don't drink bleach.
Just do cocktail making, but make it science, and I'm sure that'd be fine.
Love it.
Are we making Molotov cocktails?
There was this
you do that too.
There was this time where, because one of my biggest fears in sleepwalking is actually sleep purchasing.
Death?
Right?
Oh,
no, death isn't even killing someone. Thing for me. It's sleep purchasing. So buying something in my sleep, right? Like jumping online, buying like $1,000 something that I really want and just like clocking it in PayPal, hitting send and not even like registering that I've just spent savings on something. That's Future Rose's
problem, actually.
Exactly. So it nearly became my problem once. I had this ongoing sort of partnership for a while there with a company called Powerwave. They do like sort of accessories, gaming accessories. Shout out to Powerwave. Pro tip for any PR people out there, always communicate with your community members because there was a time that they didn't communicate with me on a particular thing. I think they were just trying to be nice. But what happened was I got a random parcel at the door, a very big box for Rose. And I picked up the box and went,
I don't remember buying anything. Ah, I've made it.
I've made it.
I know who I am.
Sleep. And so I panicked and I like busted open the box, like freaking out. I was like, what have I purchased? Oh no, like it's gonna be thousands of dollars of PC gear or something that's gonna be impossible to return. And like, you know, and then I opened up, there's this little letter on the top from Power. I'm like, hey Rose, we just want to send you a cool little fun gift. And I was like,
oh, amazing. Okay.
I don't, this is okay. We can work with this. Nobody's panicking. I'm glad I didn't overreact.
What if we use this as a strength, right? And instead we get you into sleep streams and then it can just be adventures with Rose. We'll just find out where you go. We'll get
your little Lego category. People love that stuff.
Exactly.
Yeah, a GoPro that
would be walking around your house, just randomly touching things and muttering.
And that's it.
Yeah, and then hopefully that way GoPro on you when you strip, we won't see anything.
Brilliant.
What if you walk past the mirror?
Yeah, but you won't look in the mirrors so much, right?
Because I'll cover the mirrors before I go to bed. Yeah.
Cover any shiny surfaces, but otherwise, I think we've got a really good, you know, stream idea. Don't look down.
This is great. Yeah, no.
On another note, COAG will not be participating in stripping streams. Thank you.
Man, there's so many disclaimers this time.
I know.
This is a record amount of disclaimers.
It is.
See, this, look. You know, I mean, we're all, you know, in some way neurospicy. And, you know, I think to myself sometimes my thoughts and my trains of thought are just wild sometimes. But I tell you, some gals make me feel real normal. and, you know, it's a fun time. It's a vibe. I love you to death. But my days, it's like a daycare in here. it's like a daycare. Yeah. COAG daycare, not opening soon.
That's it.
Keep your kids. I do not want them. Thank you. Absolutely thank you. Not. I'll pet
so
though.
So. Shh. No one's giving their children to you, Shay.
Wait, I don't want them. I want the animals. Gosh. Maybe the Pokemon.
Thank you, Rose, for coming on to Confessions of Pam Girl.
My absolute pleasure.
We did have a happy fun time streaming and raising money for charity last year.
Yes.
A lot of fun, despite my possessed computer. Anyway, that was a time. It was on Twitch.
We got through it.
We got through it. And you know what? Raised over $1,000 for breast cancer. So love that.
Incredible.
We should do another charity stream soon. That'd be fun.
We should. Someone else should host it. Thank you.
I can. I'm ready. Yeah. I got you.
All right.
Where's
your
brother,
dude? Always. Lovelies. Thank you again, Shay, as always, for bringing the chaos. Thank you to our beautiful, beautiful chat. Epic Treasure has just arrived, babe. And I don't know if you've been here, but, you know, we've been working. We've been talking about real stuff. So definitely go back and listen. And thank you all who are watching after the fact and also listening on Spotify and their friends. And we will see you all again next week for another episode of Confessions of a Gamer Girl. Bye.